looking for pizza, here's what we found in New Smyrna Beach. Up next on Savory Secrets. Hello and welcome to Savored Secrets. I'm Chef Costa Magoulas. We did some digging around and the mother lode we found hidden gem in the coast of Florida near New Smyrna Beach. Let's explore this Flagler Avenue pizza. I got so excited. Hey folks, this is a live show. Don't forget that, okay? Get your pencil, your paper, your phone, picture. Get this number down, 1-800-901-9238. Never been so down to the Flagler Pizza Company? Well, we have an inside look for you. We wished the Beachside Pizzeria there, and we looked at it, and we went inside, and this is what you're going to see.
Flagler Pizza. We got house salad, antipasto, Caesar, Greek.
Originally, we were from Sicily. My parents came down here from Sicily. Well, actually, New York. We started our first pizzeria in New York. And then eventually, 9 years ago, we came here and opened up Flagler Avenue Pizza.
It's years. Since I was like 10. Yeah.
Yeah, I was pretty much, I wasn't born into it, but when I was young, my father already had his first pizzeria, and I used to play with the dough when I was a kid. Eventually, I started making good pizza, and that was it. You know, then you start experimenting on different kind of pizzas, because back then it was just like normal pepperoni, you know, cheese pizza, stuff like that. Not like, well, grandma they had, but they didn't have like chicken, bacon, barbecue, stuff like that. So eventually, like through time, all these different ideas of making pizzas, and they end up selling. People liked it. Qui ti senti a casa tua, mamma mia. Qui è tutta un'euforia. Venezia è la laguna, Giulietta al suo balcone, mamma mia. Mamma mia. Mamma mia. Qui è tutta un'allegria.
We have today with us Anthony Altodana, and he's the chef owner of this restaurant. Oh man, I'm glad you're here. I really am. So let me see. He brought with him a pizza, okay? Anthony, come on over here, partner. How you doing?
Good, good, good. How about you?
What in the world did you bring us? This thing smells so good.
We brought a grandma pizza. It has fresh mozzarella, sauce, basil, garlic, and Parmesan cheese.
You know, you act like you're from Italy or something.
Oh, my family's from Sicily.
Are they really?
Yeah, I'm like first generation.
First generation?
Yeah.
Yeah, with a name like that, you'd have to be, right? Yeah. I'm the same way. Let me ask you, were you in this business all your life, or?
So I grew up in this business.
You did?
Pretty much. I started from the beginning. Before I was 10 years old, I was folding boxes. You know, when you start from the beginning, folding boxes for my father. And then.
That sounds familiar. Yeah. Did you have to wash dishes first before you let you?
Yeah. Yeah, I had to go through the hard times, but it was a good lesson. I learned a lot of recipes and family recipes, and it's been
well,
good.
You brought us a pizza here. It's a special kind of pizza. Let's have a look at this gem, how it came together, okay? So we just kind of snuck up on you and took some film, all right? Yeah. So we're going to see that right now.
Welcome to Flagler Avenue Pizza. Today, I'm going to be making you a grandma pizza. Grandma pizza is an old style pizza. We're going to be making a grandma pizza, which entails fresh mozzarella, basil, garlic, sauce, and Parmesan cheese. Instead of the sauce being on the bottom, for grandma pizza, the sauce is going to be on top. So we use a fresh made Sicilian sauce for the sauce on top of the pizza. We dab this sauce on top, then we put a little bit of Parmesan cheese, a little bit of basil, and a little bit of garlic. Right. We put it in the oven, it takes about 10 minutes to cook. Our ovens are about 500 to 550 degrees. The pizza is ready. This is our grandma pizza. It's one of our specialty pizzas. This is the one pizza that we sell the most out of all our specialty pizzas. It has that old style flavor that where the fresh mozzarella, the garlic, the sauce, the Sicilian sauce gives out a really great flavor. Now we're gonna cut it and you guys are gonna try it. You will love this pizza.
Wow, I love it. I love to see you're baking in a deck oven.
Yes.
People understand what a deck oven is. That's a flat oven.
They make the crust crispy on the bottom. Also, the way it cooks.
See, that's old school. Yeah. I'm with you 100%. I think you make the best breads and pizza in there. You said it's kind of New York style. So.
Yeah. Well, my original, when I came down here, New York pizza is, you know, when you walk in a New York pizzeria, you got the selection of pizzas.
Right.
And when I came down here, there was nobody that was doing it down here. And when I saw that corner, I was like, oh, that would be perfect.
You mean you're not from Florida? Kind of could tell.
Yeah, right. So I saw that corner and I said, people could come off the beach, get a slice of pizza, you know, go back to the beach. And you can walk around with it. It seemed perfect for the area.
I'm telling you, I looked at that menu and I keep saying that. 35 different pizzas. No. I got to ask you about one of the pizzas. It caught my eye. Firecracker pizza. What is that?
That's okay. You ever tried a long hot pepper?
Yeah.
When I tell you, I think the long hot pepper is one of my favorite hot peppers. So I decided to make a pizza with the long hot pepper and the hot supersada. Hot supersada is amazing. So we cut up the hot supersada and then we make a grandma pizza, and we just put the hot supersada in the long hots, and if the flavor of the hot supersada, the long hots, and the grandma, it's just perfect.
You know, you say grandma, I'm getting the impression that was her recipe originally?
The sauce, yes. Well, grandma pizza originally started in a square on a pan.
Really?
So we make it like this, but we can make it in a pan like original grandma pizza.
You know, you've been to Italy, obviously.
Yeah.
I had a chance to take my family there. And I saw square pizzas there.
Yeah.
And when you said square, I went, oh my goodness. But I was just overwhelmed by the quality of the pizza. Oh. And I see it again right here. Now, I know you're not going to give me your secret recipe and the cheeses, but I understand you must use a special blend for yours.
Our cheese, it comes from California, and there's a hint of buffalo. This one, actually, the cheese here is a fresh mozzarella.
Okay.
So this one's a different cheese than our cheese that we use on a normal pizza. The normal pizza is a California cheese that has like a hint of buffalo flavor.
Yeah, yeah. I tell you.
It's a high quality cheese.
Sauce and cheese, there you go. Of course, making the dough. Everything. You know, I look at this dough and it's just, I want to go.
You know how many times people tell me they deliver the water from New York?
Really?
To here. And I said, no, I use the New Smyrna. It's good water. Yep. It's just the way when you play around with the water and the flour and everything, and you mix it together, it's like you got to know what you're doing. And I think
you really hit on a big thing, water. Okay.
Yeah.
New York water is outstanding. Yeah. It's coming from the mountains, and I remember I was up in Buffalo. I said, man, this water tastes so good up here, you know. Mm-hmm. But our water has a lot of iron in it.
Yeah.
But if you filter it like you're doing, I'm sure you are,
yeah,
and it makes a big difference.
Yeah, yeah. You can make it work with the water here.
Yeah.
You definitely can make it work.
And different flours, do you use a special blend of flour or anything you want to talk about?
I do mix it with a semolina.
You don't have to give me your secret recipe.
Flour and a semolina. I do mix a different.
You do?
Yeah.
Okay. See, people don't understand flour has to really be bread flour. It has to have the protein in it, right?
Yeah.
So that it puffs up and it does it the way it's supposed to do.
And the glue, and you need the right glue.
Y'all cater it at all parties and that type of thing?
Yeah, we do. We do. We do deliver if somebody orders a tray of penne pasta, you know.
So if you order it, you deliver it, but you don't go and do catering on site?
On site.
That's a big deal. I mean, gee whiz. Probably keep you busy just making pizzas.
I mean, we just delivered, I think it was 2 months ago, 100 pizzas for the for the race that we had on New Smyrna.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How do you deliver 100 pizzas?
It's little at a time. You know, we deliver it. So we had a system that we had with the guy where we bring 20 pizzas every like 20 minutes.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm all excited about this. This is great. You know, you don't see homemade pizza that often. Mm-hmm. You know, you see a lot of this stuff that they sell in the grocery stores. And it's not even close, okay? You brought this pizza in today, and I have to tell you, when he opened the box up, I'm like, where's the box up?
I put it in.
Oh, man, that thing, smell jumped out of there. I mean, you could tell it was fresh.
Yeah.
You really could.
You smell the basil, right, as soon as you open it.
Do you make your own mozzarella sometime, or do you go ahead and buy it?
Well, that I do get it from a company
that
does, you know, it's a high quality fresh mozzarella.
It's much better.
The sauce we make ourselves, it's a Sicilian sauce, and you know Sicilian sauce is sweet with onions and, yeah.
Man, you're killing me, I'm telling you. Well, you know, you came to the show, and I wanted to do something special for you, and you have pizza. I said, well, Lord, I'm not going to do pizza, that's for sure, okay. But I wanted to do something special to honor you coming here. I really did.
What do you got for me?
Really have fun. So what we're going to do is a little something. I'm going to put something together for you, okay?
Right.
Now, I'm going to need some room here, so we're going to move this pizza over. I'm afraid to touch it. I might eat it. I'm telling you. I'm going to just go ahead and slide it.
All right.
No, you can't have any. Just let it sit right there, okay? Now, in honor of you coming, I'm going to make focaccia bread, okay? You're probably going to show me how to make it, okay? I actually made fresh focaccia. It's the most popular bread in Italy, I would assume. You see it everywhere. I even saw them taking and dipping it in coffee for breakfast. I was stunned. So you can do anything
bread
you want
with it. Bread
and coffee
is big in Italy.
Really?
Yeah.
Well,
cookies
I just
still.
Happen to
cookies
have the
still.
Dough right here, okay? So let me show you what I got. There's the focaccia bread. Now, if people are wondering, well, that's like pizza. Well, no, it's not. You know, this has more yeast in it. It's puffier. It's like a bread where the pizza is crispier and thinner. So you see the difference. This is proofed up. The recipe is very simple. Bread flour, yeast, water, or olive oil and salt. Real simple recipe. Now, I did it by hand, and I folded it 25 times.
How'd
I didn't
your hands
put it
feel after?
Well, I wanted to do old school, okay? So I squished it, and then I let it proof, and I rolled it out in this pan here and let it proof up like that. Now what you're going to do is put your ingredients on there, which is what I'm going to do right now. I take and use olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. You see me doing something wrong, don't say anything. Tell me, telling me about focaccia. Well, how do you make yours?
So I usually mix the Kalamata olives in the dough.
In the dough?
Yeah.
Dang, I didn't think to do that. You know what? I love that idea. But I use feta cheese. I can't help myself. I like feta. And don't be stingy. Put some feta on the thing, okay? Now, focaccia can be made with almost any ingredient, right?
Pretty much, yeah. I'll be honest, I never made it with feta cheese, but...
I didn't think you did either. That's why I'm going to just do something different for him, okay? And then I put calamaya olives on it.
Yeah.
Usually cut them up and chop
usually
them
up.
Usually
put rosemary on it, too. That's another thing I put. Rosemary.
Oh. See, I knew when he came on I had a problem. Y'all do, I looked at your menu, you serve more than just pizza there too.
Oh yeah, we do dinners, a few dinners, but more sandwiches and stuff like that, appetizers. So we have a very
variety
of stuff.
And yeah. Meatballs and spaghetti. And I said, holy cow, he's got 35 pizzas, then you got a whole other menu there, okay. Now this is the focaccia.
You gotta have choices when people come in.
Well, you're giving them the choices, I'm telling you.
Every time somebody comes to the counter, it's like, what's your favorite? And I was like, really, it's not what's my favorite. It's like, what are you into?
That's right, that's right. Well, this is pretty simple the way it is. I do a little salt and pepper on it. I'm going to use a little oregano.
Oregano, yeah, I use oregano.
See, he says I'm doing it right. That's good. This is Mediterranean oregano. You can smell it, tell the difference. Not like that stuff you get, you know, it's a little bit stronger than that. All right, and then I do a little kosher salt. You know, it's tough making something like that with a master pizza maker right there, I'm telling you guys. All right, Eve, where are you? I'm sorry, this is my wife, okay?
Hello.
Anytime we have food, she shows up. Okay, look, you can't have any of this, and stay away from that pizza, okay?
Sure.
You're here to work, all right? Take the pizza and put it in the oven. Be careful, it's hot.
Okay.
Isn't that pretty good, isn't it?
You gotta give her a break sometime.
Hey, I can't get her to do it at home. Be careful, that oven's hot.
Okay.
See you later.
See ya.
Okay, that was the focaccia, all right? Now, I had to make something else for you, okay, partner?
I'm interested. So
I said, well, I had to do something. So I said, let me make a simple antipasto. But it's not antipasto like you're used to, okay?
Yeah.
This will be roasted vegetable antipasto, okay? And I guess Italian antipasto means before the meal?
Yeah.
Is that the term?
Yeah.
Yeah, I never knew that. I had to look it up one time, and they said, you're doing before the meal. I was talking to a lady. She was Italian. I said, I'm what? She says, antipasto. Don't you understand? I said, I do now. All right, I got spinach in here, okay? And I'm going to start doing some vegetables on this puppy.
All right.
Chef, don't get excited. You don't have to work tonight. He started reaching for the knife.
Today.
He was going, "Where? Give me! I want to help." So I'm going to throw this in here. You want to? You can use your hands because I'm going to go ahead and kick. Just kind of mix it up as I get it done if
All
you want.
Right.
I mean, you got to work on this show. You can't just come on, okay? You like my little Sandiku knife I'm using? It's pretty nifty.
Like a squash.
I put all kinds of vegetables that are in season. I've got zucchini. That's pretty spiffy, isn't it? Hang on, Chef, I'll be with you in a second. How are we doing?
Good, good.
You know what?
I got to put the eggplant in there.
Oh, eggplant. I don't peel the eggplant, I leave the peeling on. I like to get that roasted flavor.
Yeah.
Be nice if I cut all the way through it, right?
Yeah. Should try the Sicilian eggplant. The flavor of the Sicilian eggplant.
Sicilian, is it different?
Yeah.
Is it smaller?
Yeah, it's a smaller eggplant, but the flavor is better. For me personally, I think this is.
Well, I've heard that. Now, is it a different color?
No, it's close. Yeah.
Okay. I don't know. I got some tomatoes here. look like they need to be cooked real quick. And I got some mushrooms. Yeah, tell me some more about the ingredients you're talking about in Sicily. Because we look over here, we use certain ingredients. You're back home. Do you have a home over there, your family?
My grandfather's still over there. He's actually in Sicily right now. In
going back over soon?
I am trying in 2 months.
Really?
Yeah.
Who's going to run the restaurants? That's what I'm trying to figure out.
I didn't get that far yet.
That's the only problem when you have a great restaurant doing good business. You know, who's going to run it when you're not there?
Sometimes you need to go, you need to enjoy life and
that's right.
Check out.
I also like to use whole garlic. You know, garlic, once you roast it, it's just amazing. People like to say, garlic? Yeah, that's right. How can you cook without garlic and onions? At least I try.
And then garlic and oil has to be in everything.
Now, this is red pepper I'll put in. Only reason I make a issue out of this, everybody cuts peppers wrong. You know what I'm talking about. They get up there and they cut them in half and say, what are you doing? And you come over here and start going around. We make this look like it's a surgeon, but it's not.
So my way is, that's easy.
You like that?
Yeah.
And I just put...
My way, I cut it longwise and then I gut it out and then I chop it.
I do that too sometimes to make it easy. Yeah. This is kind of for show. Everybody looking, we're putting all kinds of vegetables. My goodness, what else is he going to put in there? Oh, I got another tomato. I'll put that one in there.
What else you got in the refrigerator?
I'm looking to see what I got left. All right, here we go. Now, once we get everything in here, only thing I do to it is I use balsamic vinegar. I really like balsamic. People, you know, if you're using vinegar, you got to get balsamic. Yeah. It's almost like wine, right? It's aged. I was fortunate to see some balsamic over in Italy, the aged one. Boy, that thing really blew my mind. I was looking at this bottle, and it was like $25 or something American. I said, how long has that been aged? And I use olive oil. And, of course, oregano. And that's about it, except for one more thing. I do use a little lemon. Not a lot, you know.
Yeah.
And I usually have this little special lemon thing, but not tonight. I'm just going to use my hands. Okay, we got to get moving here.
That's good.
All right, Eve, get yourself over here. Got to earn your keep tonight. Go ahead and put that in the oven. Now, listen, when you bring that focaccia out, be careful, it's hot.
Okay, so that's ready for me to.
Yes, it is. Okay. The magic oven works fast. I know, I tried to train her. You know, what else can I do, okay? Don't burn yourself.
I know I'm using these.
Get it over here, lady.
There you go.
Now, there's a focaccia bread.
Oh, I'm going to eat those.
Yeah, I think you might. This is what it looks like, okay, gang?
Looks amazing.
That turned out good, didn't it?
Yeah.
And then, I don't know if I can take that out of there. Ooh. You know, chefs, we got chef hands, right? They don't burn as easy as everybody else. So we take that out, grab that. I'm just going to put that away and get busy here. And then all I would do is get this over here, start getting it on this plate and get it ready. But right now, I want to hurry and get the other dish. Ivan, bring that out real quick.
We kind of get close to the time here. Prosciutto, salami, some passata on a plate.
Well, what I'm going to do.
Fresh mozzarella.
There you go. I was looking for fresh. Bring it right over here.
All
right. Oh, isn't this going to be a killer? Okay, chef, here we go. There's your roasted antipasto. And we'll put that right down here. And we're going to have to get going here. Now, I usually put the salami on it, olives, cheese, and really make it into a big dish.
Oh, wow.
Okay, folks, looks like we're getting pretty close. Seems like that's all the time we have for this episode. I'm sorry we're running so quick. I'd like to thank you very much, Anthony,
thank
for coming.
You.
And folks, remember, thank you all for joining us tonight and sharing your pizza with us, especially. That was fantastic. For those looking at home, you didn't get your questions answered tonight or you didn't call in, you can email us at wdsctv@daytonastate.edu. Also, don't forget to check us out on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. Join us next week on Savored Secrets.